Hello everyone, my name is Vikram and I am basically an electrical engineering graduate and I also do Master of Science in Information Systems in Birla Institute of Technology and Science, Pilani. Currently I work as a functional head for Quality and Information Systems Division for a Singapore based group of companies. Also, I am a lead assessor for ISO 9000 standard, which is a quality management system standard, and ISO 17025, which is a core standard for calibration and testing laboratory. And I also managed to help the organization to get certified on ISO 27001, which is an information security management system and business continuity management system. And I also get exposures on testing business continuity plans and disaster recovery plans. And I also have some exposure to American Petroleum Institute standards, specification Q1, which is again a quality management system standard for oil and gas industries. The one thing which you can observe as a commonality between these ISO standards or any other ISO standard would be a continual improvement. So when you look into the definition of continual improvement, it's nothing but improving continually. What you're going to improve, it's just a process. So you are going to improve a process on a continual basis. So that's what all about. So if you want to improve a process on a continual basis, at a stretch, if you want to improve a process, then you need some information about the process. If you or some information or some historical data of the process. So before getting into this continual improvement topic, first of all, I should agree that Six Sigma is by whole heart that Six Sigma is an excellent approach for continual improvement or identifying the problems in any process. And the reason why I'm telling this is because I was part of the team that implemented Six Sigma in my previous organization and when I was a green belt holder in Six Sigma. Initially, I was part of a corporate quality team in a knowledge process outsourcing company, where we dealt with content enhancement, data management, patent analytics, and business research services. If you look back into the history, and if I'm not wrong, anything that was invented or discovered by a person from one part of the world took years for the other people from other parts of the world to know. But today, in this fast-moving and modernized world, content is being developed by the publishers and other information service providers at a rapid pace, and it is absorbed by the user even faster than the information is developed and published. Because of this instant availability requirement of the information by the customer, the information service providers find it as a biggest challenge to reduce the turnaround time. So what we did is we initially approached with, since we are dealing with the same kind of process where we find the turnaround time is a biggest problem, we initially approached with Six Sigma DMAC approach, which gave us confident and outstanding results. What we did is we initially started down, streamlined the process using SIPOC and value stream mapping, and we had a goal statement of reducing the turnaround time. To achieve this turnaround time, which we used to call it as shortly as TAT. To achieve this, we set up a team to implement this Six Sigma based approach, and we also set up a system to measure the performance of the ASIS process, the current process. And we were happy to identify that we identified many gaps in the process by itself. Gathered so many ideas, and only through a brainstorming session and from our the team mates, and we automated many processes and reduced few manual processes and eliminated many non-value adding activity, and we converted some manual processes into automated process, and we were able to reduce the turnaround time far below the client requirement. So where we realized the importance of Six Sigma. And then onwards, I realized the importance of Six Sigma, and from then onwards, the decision whatever I take on both on my personal and career pursuit was based on the data available. So if you are going to buy a mobile, then I used to use Pugh matrix, and I used to collect data from the internet, and based on the Pugh matrix, then I will select the best brand. So this is which helped me to realize the importance of Six Sigma. In the organization where I currently work with, which is a instrument solutions provider company, it's a group of company, and business from different companies in this group vary. And I am also heading in quality and information systems for this entire group of company. And in this organization where I work, we managed to implement many small improvements in many processes across the organization. But we cannot say that it is a non-Six Sigma process. But still, certain concepts in Six Sigma are achieved here. We call it lean, the way we approached, introducing small improvements in many processes across the organization, thereby leading it to a small improvement, and which lead to a big improvement. And what I think is, overall, Six Sigma is a highly disciplined process and a very interesting process, and can be implemented in any type of organization. Finally, what I would say is, any decision that is taken on gut feeling may be correct or may become correct to some extent, but not always. That's my understanding of Six Sigma. And on contrary to the gut feeling, Six Sigma is always correct. So if you are going with gut feeling, then we cannot say it is always correct. Maybe to some extent it may be correct, but if you are applying Six Sigma, then it is always correct. So if it is approached in a right way, and the processes that are identified to be improved, to my knowledge, or to based on the Six Sigma concepts which I learned, or based on the conclusions that I learned from Six Sigma, what I understand is, the processes that are identified to be improved should be aligned with business strategy, and the management should be able to feel the financial gain. So then only you can get the support from the management, and without the management support, it is difficult to implement any processes, and Six Sigma is also one of them. And to make any improvements to be successful one, you should identify the practical problem initially, and you have to convert the practical problem into a statistical problem that is based on data, and you have to convert the statistical problem into statistical solution, and then you have to convert the statistical solution into a practical solution. So which will show a disastrous results which nobody can expect. And concluding this interview, what I would say is, the successful improvement is only based on the culture of the employee, culture of the organization, and it is again based on the level of support you receive from top management, from the senior management, or from the director of the company, and it is again based on the business head and process owner of the company. So that's it. So I wish you all the best, and thank you for letting me share my experience, and all the best for your Six Sigma implementation.